7 Space Facts from TodayIFoundOut.com. Number 1. Each second, about 4 million metric tons of matter is converted to energy within the Sun's core. This gives the Sun a lifetime as a main sequence star of about 10 billion years, with about 5 billion years to go. Number 2. The surface temperature of the Sun is about 5,780 Kelvin, which is the equivalent of just under 10,000 Fahrenheit and 5,500 Celsius. The temperature at the core is much hotter, close to 14 million degrees Celsius or 25 million degrees Fahrenheit. This extreme pressure and heat allows the Sun to generate its energy from nuclear fusion at its core, fusing hydrogen nuclei into helium. This nuclear fusion is self-regulating. If the Sun's diameter gets smaller while maintaining the same mass, the pressure at the core increases, creating more nuclear fusion, which in turn causes it to expand. If it expands, maintaining the same mass, the pressure lessens in the core, resulting in less nuclear fusion going on. So a natural equilibrium has resulted in this process with the Sun, though there are stars that can be observed going through a process of massive expansion and contraction at very steady rates. Number 3. Sirius A is the brightest extrasolar star visible to the naked eye from Earth, being almost twice as bright as the second brightest, Canopus. Sirius A and Sirius B combine to form a binary star system and appear as one star to the naked eye, though the vast majority of luminosity to the naked eye comes from Sirius A, Sirius B being a white dwarf, which is only around 30 AU, astronomical units, away from Sirius A. It is theorized that there is a Sirius C, but to date, this has not been proven. Sirius A and B and possibly C combine to form a bright point known as Sirius, or the Dog Star, which is, of course, the inspiration for Sirius Black's name in Harry Potter. Number 4. Sirius A is a white main-sequence star, A1V, that is about twice the size of our Sun. The extreme brightness from our point of view comes not so much because it is a particularly bright star, but rather because it is only 8.6 light-years away, 2.6 parsecs. That's a really long way by standards of distance we normally deal with, about 50 trillion miles or so, but by galactic standards, it's just next door and is one of our nearest neighbors. Number 5. One day on Mercury, i.e. the time it takes to rotate around its axis once, lasts 176 Earth days. A year on Mercury, i.e. the amount of time it takes to orbit the Sun once, is 87.97 Earth days. In that sense, it remains daytime for a full year on Mercury, and it stays night for one full year also. Number 5. Unlike Earth and most other planets in our solar system, Venus rotates clockwise. The leading theory on why this is the case is that it initially rotated counterclockwise, but the planet flipped at some point. Number 7. A white dwarf is a former star that is nearing the end of its life cycle, with no further nuclear fusion going on at its core. Once most stars have used up the fuel at their core, they go into a red giant or super red giant phase and expand to incredible sizes. At the end of this phase, when the star has used up all its fuel that it can use via nuclear fusion, if it has enough mass, it will extremely rapidly collapse and create one of the most powerful explosions in the universe, the supernova. The burst of energy from a single supernova can briefly outshine an entire galaxy full of billions of stars. If the red giant doesn't have enough mass, it will simply collapse into a white dwarf and spend a couple of billion years slowly dimming as it gives off its stored energy. Some star remnants are too small to begin with, so don't ever go into a red giant phase. When they do go into their red phase, they are called red dwarfs. However, the lifespan of these stars is longer than the universe has existed. Thus, every star that will eventually become a red dwarf is still around today and has not reached the red dwarf phase. As a general rule with stars, the bigger and brighter it is, the faster it burns out. The smaller it is, the longer it lives. So I really hope you liked that video, and if you did like it, click like below and leave us a comment to let us know what you think. And also check out a couple of our other videos, which are linked to on the screen now, and don't forget to subscribe for brand new videos every day. Thanks for watching.